folks. Welcome to another part work video. Today we have another one from Agora Models. This is my second Agora Models part work build. And this, let's just not keep up with the suspense. Let's just open this box up and see what's inside. And I think you guys are gonna like this. It's a little different, but I think you guys are gonna appreciate this. So we are building LaFerrari. So, in speaking with my part work buddies over at Hobby Time Modelers Group, they told me that this is the most detailed car that is out there for a part work anyway. Much more detailed than maybe some of the older Mustangs, although I'd love to do one of those sometime. I just wanted to kind of have a jumping off point. And it was between these or one of the James Bond cars, and I just decided on this here because the details of this thing... This thing is just really, really sweet looking. It's not like I'm like a longtime Ferrari fan. I just like the way this looks. And we have so many details that we can look at. Under the hood, on the interior, and as you guys know on my channel here, I'm a sucker for interior details. Usually on armor, but we're gonna try this guy out. So this is pretty cool. And it's in 1/8 scale. So we got all sorts of goodies that this came with. If you've never heard of part work models before, never heard of Agora before, that's okay. I never did until I met up with the Hobby Time Modelers Group, and you know, they explained to me how it works. And basically how this works is you get a bunch of parts. Like here we can see a top of part of an engine. We have some other parts here. We even have more engine parts. We have some seats. We have a whole giant bag of screws that they're giving us in the first issue, which is pretty cool. We have some rims, which look really nice. And we have a wheel. And we have some fenders, which is really cool. I see carbon fiber in there too. This is a humongous box. This is why I really, really like Agora part works. They give you so much. Here's a hood. I mean, there's so much in the first build. And yes, there's even more. This is the last one inside this gigantic box. We have let me get this gigantic box out of the way. But we're going to keep that box because we're going to have to store parts. But we have the top of the hood. I forget the word for that. But this part that goes along the front of the car, the hood's going to close down over all this. So anyway, this looks so cool. They give you a little screwdriver too, so if you don't have screwdriver sets, they do give you some screwdrivers. This looks like a pretty nice one. I do have my own set right here. You can see all of my little tools that I have for part works. I already have it all set up. You're going to need things like some CA. I definitely recommend you have thick and thin CA if you are going to be doing any part work part work models. These wear a set of screwdrivers are really nice. They typically give you all Phillips heads. So, this is anywhere from a one down to a 000 in terms of size. And these are really nice and comfortable to work with. You're definitely going to want some tweezers. There are some small parts. Bending pliers are always helpful. So it all depends on what you want to do. In terms of tools wise, you can use whatever you want. That's just what I like to use. You are going to want some 3-in-1 oil as well. That's what this is, so a little pumper. All this stuff is available on Amazon, by the way, but you can pump a little bit of oil. You're going to want that for any kind of metallic screws, like screws going into metal is what I mean by that. So anyway, I got all this stuff out. Let me just get organized here, and we're going to start with stage one, and we're going to work our way through this awesome looking car that's going to be like the size of my desk when we're done. So anyway, we'll be right back when I get this all organized. All right, folks, so stage one is this front nose and the Ferrari badge and the rear plate. So this is actually die cast metal, this part, and then like I said, we do have the screwdriver. And no matter who you get your part work through, so for us here in the US, we have Agora and Fan Home. Agora offers some like faster options, like in terms of ship, like you can get more parts, more packs faster, you can build up faster. So like their base subscription is 12 months, so you can have a model build up in a year. And it costs the same as if you went over to the Fan Home and got their 24-month package, or it's about 24 months to build some of their stuff up. So price-wise, they're this about the same. But in terms of how it works, like, so Fan Home actually gives you a magazine with all their stuff, with all sorts of information for the build you're working on. Lots of really cool history and, you know, behind-the-scenes stuff, especially for, like, movies and whatnot. And then Agora, what they do is they have all their instructions on their website. So you can actually see all the instructions before you even get started, which is really cool if you're interested in the builds. You don't need to have an account to look at the download center and actually see all the parts that go into a build and kind of how the packs are broken up. And the other thing Agora does, which I really like, is they offer like accelerator packs. If you're like really interested in the model and maybe you don't want to wait even a year because you're impatient like me, you just want to build something, they actually have options where you can get like, for ones that aren't like freshly out, you can usually get like 3 packs at once or something, like an accelerator pack, which is pretty cool. So just trying to get all these little parts. Just watch you don't lose this little badge. Okay, and then this screwdriver. This is actually one of the nicest, if not the nicest screwdriver I've seen come in a part work, I'm not going to lie. So I'm not going to throw it out, I'm going to keep it. I'm just going to put it over here in my little stash. Alright, so now we got all that out of the way. Let's see what we got to do. Alright, so for this first stage, all we're going to do is attach the nose plate here. The nose plate. So the little Ferrari icon, we're just going to actually put that right here on the front nose, and I don't think we have to glue it. It says you can add a very small drop. You know what, let's just add a small drop, because my luck is this will just fall out. We're gonna add a really small drop of super glue in here, and again I'm using thick CA, so you can get this stuff on Amazon, anyone will work. I mean, I like using BMS when I'm working with photo etch. I have like every BMS CA there is for dealing with photo etch, but that's on my tank models, and that just snaps right into place. You guys could hear that maybe just snap into place there. That's so nice. Alright, and that is this stage complete. Stage one was just putting the logo on the front there, and then we have our rear plate, so this is something we're gonna store for later. And we're actually going to move on to the next stage, stage two, which is actually the driver's seat. So we're just going to set this aside and grab stage two right out of the pack. All right, and here is our stage two. So we have some really cool looking seats. I mean, for some of us, this is kind of like what our gaming chairs look like, because this is kind of what they molded them after, you know, all that support and whatnot. For going through all them turns at, you know, 200 mile an hour or however fast this thing goes. Get all of our parts out of here. Now these are an ABS. So one thing to note with these part work builds is that everything is made of like either ABS. Some of them, sometimes there's like a rubbery plastic that they use, and then you have die cast metal. So like these are ABS, which is why you don't want to use like styrene cement on them. You just want to use CA. So this should be pretty straightforward. We do need to get some screws. So one thing that's unique to this build, for me anyway, so this is my 6th part work build. It's crazy. It's like one of those things where once you start, you just can't stop. But typically, they give you like a little pack of screws in the stages you need them, or like the stages before. But in this case, Agora did something pretty cool, in my opinion. And they gave you all the screws up front, and all the bags are labeled. I know my other Agora model, the Zero Fighter, which is actually a Hachette one, it's a Hachette model from the UK, which they just started delivering to the United States. I think the submarine that they're offering, you can get over here. But anyway, they're not labeled, and I had the heck of a time trying to figure them out, because I did not organize them from stage one, and that was shame on me. So anyway, these are already labeled, so what we're looking for is screws type B. So there's somewhere in this bag is a B. I'm going to find them, and then we're going to start putting this chair together. Alright, so we found our bag of B screws with the letter B on it, and I got 3 of them out, as the instructions call out for. So let's see how this is all going to go together. So It looks like we're going to be taking our main seat here, and then we have the front upholstery. That's the front upholstery, and then there's the base. So we're just going to be setting these together. So if you take notice here, I'll just zoom in for a bit so you guys can see that a little bit clearer. We have some alignment pins here, which is really nice. So we can easily just slap these together, just like that. And now we actually have a seat. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna take two of these three screws that I grabbed, and they're gonna go right here and here. So now, remember I said about using 3-in-1 oil for when you're putting screws into metal parts. In this case, we're putting screws into plastic parts, so there's no need to do that. I mean, can you? Sure. Is there any benefit? Probably not. So, using our screwdrivers, we're just going to insert these screws. Now, whenever you're trying to do more than just one screw, I like to like start them both and then tighten them down, or else you could get it to be a little crooked. Anybody who's ever changed tires knows what I'm talking about. So, let's just make sure that that is seated properly. I mean, this seat is just massive. I know it's 1/8 scale, you know, but I'm just so used to dealing with my 1/35 scale, or at biggest, my 1/16 scale tanks, and this is bigger than all that. So anyway, there's our piece there. Now we have the backrest. So this actually is a snap fit, but we can apply some glue, so it's just going to sit back here. So I think just to make myself feel better, we're going to apply just a little bit of CA inside here, just because it makes me feel better to have a little bit of something. But it does say that if it is a secure press fit, but if you want to add glue, you can. So I like that. So I just like to add a little bit. We're just gonna put a few dabs, just in a few spots. I just would make me feel better if I had a little bit of CA. That's all. So we're just gonna snap this here. I can see it's a press fit. There we go. Beautiful. All right. And that's what it looks like so far. We still have the headrest to do, but that's pretty cool. Really big part. I mean, I have big hands, and that's a big part. So, I'm a big guy. So, if this thing looks big in my hands, it's because it's pretty big. So, the last one is the headrest as well. So, this too is a nice snap fit, but just because it makes me feel better, I'm going to put a little bit of CA on here. So this is, to me, this is kind of like the Bandai kits we've been building on this channel here, the Perfect Grade, Falcon, and then I have, I got into the rabbit hole of Gundams lately, and it's all snap fit, but even there, I'll find myself using some cement. But anyway, man, that looks so good. I even like the little Ferrari symbol that's like on the top of this headrest. It looks so good. And with that, that's stage two complete. All right, stage three, we have a tire. We have another piece of the front end there, it looks like, and we also have, I think this is like the lower spoiler, right? The what's it called? The aileron. Yeah. So we have a front splitter and an aileron we're going to be putting on here. So let me get this out of the box here, and we'll have at it. All right, so now that we got everything out of the box, we have this tire with foam inside, and we're gonna leave that in there. That's not just packing material, that actually gives it some rigidity so you don't look like you have a flat tire. Then we have the front splitter. This is actually made of PVC, but it has a beautiful carbon fiber finish on it, which looks really nice. And then we have the aileron, which is made of die-cast metal. So we're actually gonna be using 5 of the A screws, okay? So I have a baggie of screws right here, A screws. And we're going to be using those to attach all this stuff. So starting with the aileron, we're actually going to attach that to the front, the nose here. So this actually has nice alignment on it for a die-cast piece. So it actually just sets in here like so. And then we're going to attach it. So because we're going to be screwing die-cast into die-cast, we are going to be using our 3-in-1 oil. So essentially what you want to do, if you never use one of these little pumpers before, is just pump it so you get a little bit of oil up top there. And then just dip the end of your screw into the 3-in-1 oil. And you don't need to like soak in it, just get the tip of it in there and then place it in its spot. And that, what that's going to do is just reduce the friction when you're putting in your screw into die cast, because it's metal on metal contact, so there's a lot of friction. It's going to save your hand too. Well, really, that's really what's going to help. You're going to get a better fitment, and you're not going to be like killing your hand to tighten this screw, because get rid of the friction. So that looks pretty good. I just want to make sure it's tight all the way. It's not going anywhere. That's really nice. Put that aileron on there. Oh, it looks a little crooked. Or did I just move it? Or did I tighten it too hard and strip the threads? That could have happened too. Not coming off though, so must be in there. Alright, but it's only one screw holding it in there. Alright, so the next step is to attach the front splitter. So, same thing. We have, if we take notice in here, we have a few places where we can screw these holes fast. Zoom in back. I can only zoom in so far because these parts are just so massive. Again, you can see I'm holding this with two hands, how big it is, right? So it's very, very, very large. And the splitter is going to fit in here, and there's some mounting points here for us. So you can see there's four different places here where we're going to put some screws through. And we're going to use the same A screws. Now we are going into die cast, so again, we're going to want to put a little bit of 3-in-1 oil on these. I'm going to pump this again because I don't think there's enough there. There we go. I feel like since Part Works have taken off, these pumpers are so much more expensive on Amazon, because they know a bunch of us are using these, and they're like, hey, we're going to up the price from $7 to $15. That's how expensive these things are sometimes. Anyway, just a little pumper I'm talking about, which is just kind of weird. But anyway, so we're going to line that up, dip our screw in our 3-in-1 oil, we're just going to start at one end, we're just going to get these started. Now, you don't have to worry about tightening them in any kind of sequential order. This isn't actually installing, you know, your tires on your car. You're not trying to get a perfect concentric circle tightened down, but it's just a habit of mine to at least get all the screws started and then tighten them down. It makes it a lot easier. So again, I'm just dipping this in 3-in-1 oil, putting them in place. It is nice to have a pair of screwdrivers, or a set of screwdrivers with the magnetic tips on them. That's much more helpful. So I'll just tighten them down until they're snug. You really don't need to over-tighten anything on these. Beautiful. Again, I really like, I just love the Agora model, so I just did the Zero Fighter before I did this one here, and it's just, it's incredible how much content you get in a pack. You know, you're getting anywhere from seven, I think the first one here is seven stages, but then after this you're gonna get like 14 or 15 stages. I mean, you do the math over 12 months, all the stages you get, it's just so good. It's so nice to have so much content to build, and I mean, just look at that. That is beautiful. I love the carbon fiber finish on this. The paint is flawless, no issues that I can see. I mean, this is just a beautiful model so far. And that's actually this stage complete, so let's move on to the next one. All right, so stage four, we have a nice wheel and a hub with the Ferrari logo on. So all we're gonna do in this stage to start anyway, is we're going to get our hub out, and this is another press fit one, but we'll put a little CA on it because just why not? I mean, don't want to risk it. Actually, we should probably read the instructions first because it doesn't tell us to do that. Why wouldn't we put the hub on though? That's weird. Okay, so it doesn't say to put the hub on yet. Let's just go ahead and put this back in its bag so we don't lose it. It actually says to take this, which is, by the way, is die cast. You can hear that on my ring. And it looks like it doesn't really matter which side. Wait. This tread's asymmetrical. Is there a certain way? Yeah, so it looks like this tread goes on the outside. Yep. So this tread here, you take notice that it's asymmetrical. You have this special tread here. This is for like throwing the water out if the road's wet. This goes towards the front. Right, see the back of the wheel, front or inside of the wheel and outside of the wheel. And this just goes over top of this. Now it does say if you struggle to just actually put this in hot water. So let's just take a look here. Yep, that's all this does is it makes sure that you have it looks like it's inflated. Yep, I just want to double check. So we're just going to snap this in. I don't think that's giving me too much trouble at all, so no reason to soak it in hot water. This is going in real nice. Beautiful. Just make sure we get that seated properly. And look at there. We have a wheel. Looks like it's seated good in the inside too. Tire, I should say. Wheel and a tire. Look at there. Beautiful, huh? Look at that. I love it. All right. Let's take a look at the next stage because that's stage four complete right there. All right, in stage five, we're going to be looking at the bonnet. So let me get this out of the pack and we will take a look at this. All right, folks, now that we got the bonnet out of the pack, we also had two mounting brackets and we need two of the C screws for this stage. So I got those two out. One thing to note, I did read back through the instructions and this hubcap from the last stage does have to just be kept separate. It does say that this will be installed later in the build, so we're just going to keep that safe with the first wheel. Now, this bonnet and these mounting brackets goes on pretty straightforward. So we have this back side here. I love the matte finish on that. Oh, that's so pretty. Between the gloss and the matte, I always love gloss, bright colors with like that flat black look. It just makes the colors pop. I love it. It's one of my favorite things. So anyway, we have these mounting brackets. These are plastic and they're gonna be screwed in place. The bonnet is die cast. So it looks like this is pretty straightforward from what I can tell. So it lines right up. You really, I don't know, it's almost foolproof because these brackets here, L brackets, they got to go facing up, at least in the direction like this here, right? So let me just zoom in for a hair. Gee, how did my dog hair get down here? This stuff gets everywhere. That's what I get for petting them this morning. Let's take a look here a little bit closer. You guys can see how that list lines up on there. I mean, it almost snaps into place essentially. So anyway, we have these C screws. We're going to first, because we're going into die cast 3-in-1 oil, you'll get sick of me saying 3-in-1 oil because this is how we're going to do anything with die cast. And there's a lot of die cast on some of these. This is probably the most amount of die cast I've gotten in pack one. Typically it's a lot of plastic parts with a little bit of die cast metal. But this is impressive how much die cast there is in pack one. So if you're interested in this, definitely check out Agora's website. They have a ton of models on there. I know I was actually looking at their Mustang models first because I do like Mustangs. So there's plenty of stuff out there. So let's actually put the bracket in place first. That'd be helpful. Yeah. All right, let's do that. Hold that in place. Do this so you guys can actually see what I'm doing. Be helpful. There. Tighten that on down. You just want to tighten them until they're snug. You don't need to go crazy. Like, you don't need to torque them or anything like that. Just make them sure they're snug. This one's still a little loose. And that's where your good screwdriver set comes in handy. And that's still loose. Why is that? There we go. Now it's snug. All right. Good. And that's that stage complete. So we got those mounting brackets on for the bonnet. That looks really nice. Gosh, this is such a cool looking car. It's all about those lines, and gosh, this car's got them. So let's move on to the next stage. All right, in this stage, we're going to be installing some bonnet details. So we have the bonnet airfoil here, and we have the bonnet vent frame here. And we're also going to need four of the D screws, okay? And we're going to use those D screws to mount these parts to the bottom of the bonnet. So first, so this is cool. This has carbon fiber on it. Carbon fiber finish looks beautiful. This is just going to set right inside here. This is the bottom side of the bonnet. We're just going to set that there like so. Okay. Then, holding that in place, we're actually going to take our airfoil, or sorry, the vent frame, and we're going to set that over top of it. So it sets into place like that. So you can see how it lines up with all the holes. Again, we are screwing into die cast, so we're going to use our 3-in-1 oil. I told you, you'd get sick of me saying that. So once we dip our screws in 3-in-1 oil, we can go ahead and start putting those in place. We just have four of these, and then this stage is actually going to be done. So it might seem like the stages are short, and in some cases they can be. Some of them, some models are extremely short, where they literally give you parts and they say hold on to them for the next stage, and you're like, oh, okay. But in this case, you do a little something each stage, and you have a lot to show for it. I mean, my desk is full of car parts right now, and I like that. And I'm only on stage, or pack one. It can be a little confusing with the packs and stages, because like when I say pack, what I'm talking about is the shipment. So this is my first shipment, because it's like a subscription, right? So every month, they send you a pack, and those packs have stages. Okay, and that's how you reference your instructions, that's how you reference how to build it. You start at stage one, and you work to whatever stage there is. So like, some kits, they go to like 120 or 130 stages or further, all depends on what they are, and how much is involved. So anyway, make sure that's good and snug. That looks snug. Let's see what it looks like from the top. Oh man, that carbon fiber. Oh man, that looks so sweet. I just love the look of this thing. They actually do offer like a limited edition version of this, and it's in all black, which is kind of cool, but then you lose all the detail. So Agora, if you wanted to make one in like a, you know, a brighter color, oh, other than red, I would totally do it. But not black. Anyway, this is really cool looking. That's this stage complete, so moving on to the next one. Alright, so for this is stage 7. We have the top of the engine. So this is the airbox specifically part. This is the airbox of the engine. And then we have some Ferrari logos that we're going to attach. These are actually little photo etch sticky back logos. And what's funny is I actually have a few of these for Bandai kits. These are like the photo etch sticky stuff that comes with some Gundam kits, which is pretty cool. So anyway, so essentially what we're going to do is we're just going to peel these off the backing using just a pair of tweezers to grab a hold of them. It's easy to peel off, but we want to grab them with tweezers. The last thing we want to do is stick our dirty fingers all over this oily skin and ruin any kind of sticky backing that's on here. So, and they're actually harder to peel off than I thought they would be. But they're definitely some nice shiny photo etch. I just want to be careful so I don't snap them. Okay, good. Alright, so now, oops, see, I don't want to do that. Alright, what we're going to do is place these over top of kind of where they have the illustration on here, so which is really nice. It's kind of like they show you where it goes. So if I can have tweezers that want to work with me today. Come on, tweezers, work with me. Work with me. They don't want to work with me today, guys. They're like, we just did all that photo etch. We don't want to work with you anymore. Oh, look at that. Right over top of there. That looks gorgeous. So shiny. It's like one of these models where it's so shiny I'm afraid to actually touch it. I'm just going to go ahead and pull this off my fingers because my tweezers are just not behaving today. To be fair, it's my backup set of tweezers. Maybe that's why. So like we're sick of being a backup tweezers. Well, okay, you're going to stay there. Yep. Just line this up. Okay, nope. Sorry, backup tweezers. You need to come into play because my fingers are just too big to line that up. Oh, look at there. Beautiful. Well done, tweezers. Just a guy talking to his tweezers. Nothing wrong with that. All right, there we go. That's that stage complete. That really is all there is to this stage. But again, this is the airbox for the motor. Look how big that motor is going to be in 1/8 scale. I mean, that's beautiful. We do have one more stage left in pack one. I know, it's like, it just keeps going. This is how these Agora packs are. It just keeps going. And I can tell you that pack one, they ease you into it. There's half as much in pack one as there is in all the other packs, at least in terms of the parts and whatnot. And like pack 2 through 12, there's like twice as many parts. Wow, so much content. I love it. All right, we'll be back. I'll get the next one unpacked for you guys. All right, for the last stage in pack one, this is stage 8. We have our left-hand head cover, so top of the engine, and then we have some foam that goes in there as well, the head cover gasket, and then we have the plug caps for this. So we're actually going to be doing quite a bit of assembly, so this is pretty cool. These are the details I like. Now, you are going to need a pair of nippers for these. I don't think you need anything special necessarily, because the way they have these molded, it looks like the part you're going to nip off is going to be not seen. So all you're going to want is any pair of nippers, but like I have these. These are God Hand red handles, so these aren't super, super precise, but they're nice single-bladed nippers just to be able to cut these parts off the sprue. And like I said, this part is not going to be visible, so no big deal. But anyway, let me take a look at these instructions and we'll see what we're going to do. All right, so we're only going to nip out 4 of our plug caps. So I nipped off 4 of those. We're just going to set these off to the side. I wouldn't recommend cutting these off until you actually need to use them, because it's easier to keep them safe, keep them stored. We only need one of these foam gaskets. We're going to be using the second one later, I think, for the other side, which will be in a future pack. So to start, we're going to take our red piece here, and we're going to just put this gasket over top of here. Note that this side here is a little bit bigger, and you want to make sure your gasket matches up to there. And that's all you're going to do is just set that there. It'll hold. We don't have to glue it or anything. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take 4 of these plugs and put them in place. Now, if I zoom in here for you guys, you can see that there are little notches here. So basically, you can only really put these in one way, at least that's how it's explaining it. So essentially what we're going to do is look at our parts, and you see there's a little notch there as well, just on the one side. So we want to make sure that we put in our 4. Specifically, what we're going to do is we're going to put in these 4 here. So you can see how these 3 are turned one way, and then this one here is turned differently. And again, it all has to do with that notch. So essentially what we want to do is just press fit these in. Now, you can put some CA in, and I likely will. Just to show you guys how easy that is to just set in there. And it's probably not going to come out. It actually is. It's press fit. So maybe we'll just press fit these in. And I was wrong about not being able to see those ends, but I think we're going to tie something into this eventually. I could be wrong. Either way, if you have a good pair of nippers, you can see how cleanly I nipped them off with a pair of God hands there. So just press fit these 4 in. And again, you really can't screw it up because they have a notch there for you. So then, like I said, this last one here is going to be in a different direction because of that notch. Wasn't it this one here? No, wait. Are all those notches the same? Is there a different part? Hold on. I think the plug caps are all the same. Just double checking. Yep, all the plug caps are the same. Oh, I started one down too far. That's why. I said I was going to do these four, and then I started here, because I don't know why. There must be a reason they tell you not to put one here, though, so we're just going to take them pliers or tweezers and pull it out. Let's put this guy here, because I was like, man, it's supposed to be three in one direction, and then a fourth one, another one, so. All right, that's why we didn't put CA on it. Imagine if we did, we would have had a mess, so. There we go. And there's our four. And that is stage eight complete. So everything else that's loose, we are going to store somewhere safe. All right, folks, that's it for pack one of the Agora models LaFerrari. So just to recap, we finished up the nose piece of the front end of the car, right? So, I mean, that looks really nice. We got the carbon fiber. We got almost all die cast. I'm going to have to, like, get some wipes down here to keep this thing from getting full of my dirty fingerprints. We have our seat finished up. We have a wheel put together with a hubcap ready to go. We got our airbox done. We have these parts done here, and we have a few loose parts, and we also have our bonnet put together. So that's everything that came in pack one. So let me know what you guys think down in the comments section. If you like this video, leave a like. Also, subscribe if you want to continue to see this series, because this series is going to take about a year to complete. So definitely want to subscribe so you can check out how this build goes, see how it progresses. And if you're interested in this model yourself, it is available on Agora's website. You can go ahead and check that out. I'll put a link down in the description for you guys. But anyway, one last thing is just a quick shout out to my Patreons, which I'll have floating somewhere here on the screen for you guys. I appreciate all the support from you guys. And again, if you guys want to check out my Patreon and support my work, I'll leave a link in the description for you guys as well. But that's it for this build for today. We'll see you guys soon. Thank you.